Hi, I'm Rich with Loft Labs. For a while now, our product Loft has allowed users to spin up virtual clusters, which are lightweight Kubernetes clusters that run inside regular namespaces. These virtual Kubernetes clusters allow companies to give their engineers direct access to Kubernetes in shared multi-tenant clusters. Users are admin in their virtual clusters, but in the underlying Kubernetes cluster, they have no admin privileges. Over 90 companies are using Loft today and are taking advantage of virtual clusters to provide Kubernetes self-service for their engineering teams. So far, our virtualization technology for Kubernetes has been proprietary. Today, I'm very excited to announce that we're open sourcing our virtual cluster technology called vCluster. With vCluster, anyone can now spin up virtual clusters on top of their favorite Kubernetes platform, even without being a Loft customer. Let's take a quick look at how vCluster works. vCluster is simple. It doesn't require an operator or any CRDs. It's as easy as deploying the vCluster Helm chart or running kubectl apply. However, for an even easier experience, I'll be using the vCluster CLI to show you how fast we can spin up virtual clusters with a few commands. I've already installed the vCluster CLI on my laptop. It's a simple client-only Go binary that you can download from GitHub. For this demo, I'll be using a Kubernetes cluster running in Docker Desktop, but you can use vCluster with any Kubernetes cluster. First, let's create a vCluster called vCluster 1. We're specifying host namespace 1 as the namespace in our demo Kubernetes cluster that this vCluster should be running inside of. After the vCluster has been deployed to the host namespace, let's connect to the vCluster API server. This command starts port forwarding, but you could also set up an ingress to expose this vCluster via an ingress controller. Since we're using port forwarding, we'll leave that command running in the background and open a new shell. Besides starting the port forwarding, the vCluster connect command automatically creates a kubeconfig file by default. Let's tell kubectl to use this kubeconfig file by setting the kubeconfig environment variable. And now let's look at our namespaces. As you can see, the namespace we created called host namespace 1 doesn't exist here because we're inside the vCluster now, and we're not inside the underlying Docker Desktop cluster. Our host namespace 1 exists in the real cluster, and our virtual cluster has its own virtual namespaces separate from the underlying cluster. The only thing running in this vCluster is core DNS and the vCluster pod itself. Let's create a new namespace inside the vCluster. And then we'll look at our namespaces and see demo Nginx. Now, let's create a simple demo deployment. Great! Since our vCluster has a controller manager that controls the replicas of our deployments and stateful sets, we can find a new pod inside our vCluster now. Awesome. The pod is running inside the vCluster, and everything is working just like using a regular Kubernetes cluster. Now let's see what actually happened behind the scenes inside our underlying host cluster. I'm switching back to my regular kubeconfig file that points at my Docker Desktop cluster. And let's look at the namespaces. As you can see, the demo Nginx namespace we created inside the vCluster does not exist inside our underlying host cluster. That's because vCluster's API server stores everything inside a separate data store. By default, that's a simple SQLite database, but we could also use a full-blown etcd cluster as a data store for our virtual cluster. vClusters live entirely inside a single namespace of the host cluster. Now let's check what's inside our host namespace. Our demo Nginx deployment doesn't exist inside the real cluster. It's entirely virtual and only exists inside the vCluster. Let's check the pods as well. Aha! So the pod that runs our demo Nginx application is actually running inside the host namespace. That's because the virtual cluster cannot schedule any pods. It doesn't have real nodes and it doesn't have a scheduler. Instead, it has a syncer, and this syncer synchronizes the pods from the virtual cluster down to the underlying host cluster. No matter in which namespace inside the virtual cluster these pods are created, they all land in the same host namespace. Okay, so why are we doing this? Well, first of all, Kubernetes clusters are very expensive, and creating new clusters over and over again is a huge cost driver. However, sharing clusters and multi-tenancy is really hard. vCluster allows multiple users and teams to have their own virtual clusters that run on top of a single shared host cluster. Apart from the additional security and stability benefits that virtual clusters offer, by splitting up users into their own virtual clusters, this approach saves a ton of cost because we can easily auto-scale vClusters, and because they're very lightweight and easy to spin up and down again. Virtual clusters are very low overhead. They run with the super slim K3S API server, and since K3S is a certified Kubernetes distribution, virtual clusters are 100% API compliant. vCluster users won't even notice that they're not running inside a real cluster. The possibilities that virtual clusters offer are endless. You could run different Kubernetes versions, enable alpha or beta flags for certain users, or even test a new ingress controller without disrupting operations in the underlying cluster. You can even run virtual clusters inside virtual clusters, and you won't see any network or performance degradation for running pods inside your vCluster. Remember, as we saw in the demo, our pods are actually running inside the underlying cluster, which makes them just as performant as if we would have scheduled them directly inside that cluster. I could tell you a lot more about the benefits of virtual clusters, what our customers are doing with them, what amazing features we have on our roadmap, but I'm sure the most powerful thing for you would be to try out vCluster yourself. vCluster is now open source and available on GitHub. You can learn more at vcluster.com.